Finally gone, Jesus.
Actually, I started recording at the beginning of that whole announcement thing, and I'm gonna start a new episode now. This is where I'm gonna look label at it this. When I upload it. This is the important information episode.
Look at this. Look at this art mock-up for Abigail. Did such a good job on this. Proper night Abigail now. Well, she's not a night night, but
I'm
she's
surprised
supposed to
know. That like coloring this was not at, or like making these two.
Yeah, you got that one good. Like all like the first try, like the coloration of that. That worked out really well.
Fei Chong Hao.
You're so stupid. That is Fei Chong. I didn't recognize the armor. Fuck.
You did.
I'm so dumb.
Silas is traumatized. It's fine. You can be dumb.
Silas doesn't give a shit. They're not there.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Yeah, so, you know, good old Abigail, bring him back. He is a Twinsian native, contrary to her original, original iteration backstory. Definitely didn't make her like it. So, Silas, you go off, huh? And apparently, Oriana is sticking around to keep tabs on you. I don't fucking know.
Well, Silas didn't go anywhere.
Okay, well, there we go, then.
They were staring
at you. You two are left to your own devices. We can go to Redain and Sajar at a later point. There's only four people in this call other than me right now, so that's okay. Well, Sonya doesn't count as a person.
Does she?
She doesn't.
Sonya's a man.
Not at all.
Oh, I thought you said she does.
No, she doesn't. Not at all.
She's fucking
elf. That's why I was like, yeah, there's four. What do you mean?
So, what are you guys doing?
We're adding... No, she goes over in this section. Right about there.
She's not in your guys' company yet. I'm, you know, maybe she won't. Maybe she'll die in the fight.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
What is going to happen? She has a pretty... She has
before.
She has before.
Oh, she did!
Yeah. She has a pretty disgusting build, I will say. It wasn't even like when I was trying to build, it just sort of happened.
It's like, oh god.
Nice.
Let's see. So she has a... Well, this isn't part of the build, but it's just nice because I just wanted to grab some stuff from Sir Grayson. She can exude an aura protection. But it's not like a permanent aura protection. It only lasts like one round. So that's very nice.
That's nice.
But yeah. She has this ability, which is like, okay, when you make an attack, you can cause a target to... be distracted by it. It's like sort of like Ancestral Barbarian, but the Sovereign Guard Ranger shit. So yeah, it's like, okay, if you hit a target, they'll have disadvantage on all other targets except you. Pretty good.
Objection.
But, first off, she has Polearm Master, so she could do that after a target runs up to, like, say, Orianna, and they just do that and cuck them at the last moment. But the other point is she also has Lunging Attack, and... But wait, there's more. I didn't put... Wait, where is it? Okay, I can't find it. She has Charger. So she could, in theory... Because she has Roving, which is the Ranger thing. The revised Ranger thing. She could run 70 feet. And then lunging attack someone, putting her 10-foot range to a 15-foot range. So she could hit a target 85 feet away and then cause them to have disadvantage on all other targets except her. So she really can tank, if needed.
Crash, you've done it. You've created the female version of Guan Yu.
I guess I have, Good coloration for it, too.
Color.
Yeah, even the color, yeah.
Good I am.
We've done it! Inadvertently. Anyways, so that's her build. Nasty build. Well, it's a fun tank build. But anyways, what are Silas doing?
I was gonna say, if you guys want to do your thing first, I gotta go for like 2 minutes. I'll be right back.
Okay, never mind then. I'm assuming Orianna is just keeping tabs on Silas, then.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, Orianna can't go anywhere. It's about her.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, it's about you. Congratulations. You've been targeted.
Ha ha ha. I have been chosen as a fucking enemy.
Hi, Tango.
Cat update.
He's been with me this whole time. He's been sleeping on the chair.
Oh, okay. I stood up at my desk. It feels so much nicer to stand up right now.
Meanwhile, be me standing this whole time. I need to update my resume later today and send it off to my friend to maybe get a new job. Yeah, I told him I'd do it this weekend. I don't want to do it tomorrow, so...
It's an hour earlier, but significantly more pay.
Yeah. And it's way closer and better traffic conditions. Yeah, that would be nice. Assuming I get it, but the way he sounds like they're desperate, so. Yeah, I just feel bad for leaving my team currently, but at the same time, I'm also like, I'm just a loan assist.
Yeah.
So I need to update my resume, and that's why I decided to drink this energy drink when I went to get a drink earlier. Because I was like, I don't really need energy right now. But then I was like, I still want to make that resume today, or touch on my resume today, so I need extra energy. And here we are. Here we are. Sucks that, you know, Alec had to pop out early, but again, it's nothing tragic, so that's it's good. I guess in the meantime, is Shajar doing anything in particular at the bar, or is he just sort of enjoying the evening? Secret Blake does sit with you, as does Kasai.
Yeah, I did want to have a little chat with Kasai.
She's there.
Yeah.
She's ordering just some mead.
Mead?
Today was not what I... Today was a very weird day. A very cruel day.
I wholeheartedly agree.
She drinks. Silas is taking it worse than the rest of us. I can tell. Not too surprising. But she takes another drink. It is not welcome.
It's never easy losing someone you care about or for.
That is true, but there is a certain...
Awesome, I'm changing the music. This is way too happy.
Wait, it's a depression alcohol music.
You mean Oriole's Ascension? The best music ever?
Agreed, yeah, statistically.
But yeah, she continues. Because I continues.
It is one thing for someone close to you to leave. But it is another cruel factor for it to happen so suddenly. So out of nowhere. If any of us fell facing the Grandmaster, I think that would have had less impact than what happened this morning.
Absolutely true.
Takes another drink. I would know. It is not an easy thing. And given how Silas is, I imagine it must hurt even more.
Yeah, I've been thinking about the fight we had with the Grandmaster. And I've come to realize that I don't think I know everybody as well as I would like to.
Yes, that is not too surprising, given how many of us there are. And given how different we all are, it is no surprise that Amber and Zol get along so well. Same for you and Redain.
Yes.
It merely happens.
Silas is a mystery, an enigma in many ways, and I suppose it's the chaos in the nature that confounds me. With Oriana, though, we are not quite oil and water, but I find it difficult to understand her.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, with Silas, or with Redain, I understand where they are coming from. I understand what drives them. I understand why they do what they do. Or at least I assume I do.
Mm-hmm.
With Orianna,
you are less sure.
Yes. In some ways, she's a little bit like Amber. Very transactional in their relationships. It's give in order to get.
Hmm.
Not what I'm used to.
She takes another drink.
You're right. I can see that. But that is simply how she is. No?
Indeed.
Is it something you would want changed?
Absolutely not. I simply wish to understand, but I don't want to change a person. If they are a certain way, then that's how they are.
Here's a drink.
Well,
Sorry, go on.
No. I was just saying, we are seeing more of Orianna now. So perhaps she was to change yet anyways.
That's what I was hoping, yes. I forgive me if this is rude, but you have had more time than most of us, I suppose, standing aside and observing the whole of us.
She has a smirk on her face. Yes.
It is a role I am familiar with.
Even in my own tribe, I was like this. I had to.
And I do not mind it.
I was about to say that I think that you are very wise.
And she shakes her head, chuckling.
Hear me up. I think that there are two ways to be wise. One is the wisdom that comes with experience, with life, with age. The kind of wisdom you look for in a mentor or a teacher. And then there's the kind of wisdom you get by paying for it. And usually the only currency that's accepted is pain. And I think you understand pain very well.
Understand? No. I just merely think.
She looks at you. Looks at Blake, who's just sort of listening in, but doesn't really have much stake in the conversation.
I just think that I have different take on pain than you, or anyone. Not me specifically. Nevros. Northern Nevros. Southern Nevros. Provincials. It still hurts. It just hurts different.
Absolutely.
Like this morning, losing Brendan. I don't feel much pain for this. Maybe this is because me and Brendan, not so close, not like he was with Silas. But it's also a matter of I saw it coming. One does not court fairies, elementals, his plaything for them, and survive long. And that is, I think, Nevro's thing. We know when others are making mistakes that will cost them pain, lives. We are more exposed to it. And she looks at Seeker Blake. People here in the Twins, I think they are also associated with this. But Twinsian people have this back notion of hope, of fairness, justice, that the world is cruel and there is justice to be had after the cruelty. That is not Nevros in Northern, in the North. That is not how we think. World is harsh, is cruel, not because it is trying to be cruel, usually, in normal circumstance. No. Life is a struggle. Pain, death, mistakes that lead to them. That is everywhere. It's normal. It will always happen. There's no right, no wrong. That is just how it is. There's no vengeance against life for being cruel.
No, I don't suppose there is.
But she leans back and takes a big swig of her mead.
I am but one northerner here. I'm sure there are many in the north that disagree. And just as many south that do as well. So, that is just my thoughts.
Well, thank you for sharing.
Aye, that's a different take on us Twinsians, I wouldn't expect. Can't say it's wrong either. Ugh. If I'm being honest with all of you lot, I'm a bit excited for this operation. Probably one of the biggest things that's happened in a while now. Happy to be a part of it.
Yeah, I can see that.
So, he looks at Kasai. Maybe it is just a provincial thing for vengeance and justice. Don't mean it's a bad thing though, innit? I suppose not.
I think that the Twinsian idea of justice is sharper than our concept of it in the exchange.
Quiet and contemplation. Trying to think, because neither of them have much of a metric on Fajan and culture and stuff like that. Blake is, you know, Twinsian, and Kasai's probably never even been there.
Ah, let me put it this way. Say, for example, that you run a business. There is a competition across the street. One slights the other, maybe does something underhand, breaks the law. What do you do?
Blake just sort of like crosses his arms and is just like, ugh. Meanwhile, Kasai just goes, I go over and beat the shit out of them and fix things myself.
See, you got the right idea of it. But without the violence. Where I'm from, we tend to maneuver, scheme, ruin, dispossess, arrange things in such a way that they cannot be traced back to us.
Sounds like a fucking fairy.
In some ways, yes. I can see the similarity. I think that the recompense in our view is more just when it is psychological in the mind or in the spirit rather than physical of the flesh. When the world circles around coin, that's generally what happens. But, Blake, let me ask you something different.
Hello? What do you got?
Take a big swig of my drink. So. What would you say about a person who traveled all across the provinces through the Twins into the Hillands and beyond?
I'd say that adventurer.
On the, not even a promise, on the possibility, the idea of chasing, perhaps not even love, but the answer to a question, if there is love, between them and another.
He just looks at you, like with this, like, oh man, this is really specific, huh? I wonder what this could be in relation to, huh?
Oddly suspicious.
Yeah, he's like, oh, it's oddly specific, yeah, he just looks at you. I'd say that's a fool in love, whether or not he realizes it or not. You know, if there ain't no such thing as love, which I would contest. Josiah, like, looks off and away as the two of you are having this conversation. I'll be right back. She gets up. Walks over. Away to a different part of the tavern. We'll get to that shortly. Why bring this up?
Because I am a fool.
I think you are a fool. But it is more to folly to be fools. What's more important is that we learn from it, hey? That's what they always taught us back in secret academies.
Academies.
Yeah, I guess you
would have something like that.
Yeah, call them academies, it depends. We get shuffled around for different parts of training. Most of the early day stuff is spent in Seeker Tower down Sevlis. Lots of learning, different stories, methodologies, even some crafts if you're capable for it. We get put through, I guess you call it an aptitude test, see where we're best at. Some of us are good at archery, some are, I guess, are good at fast strikes, some of us even are able to magics and stuff like that. Some of us even get into gadgetry, how to build it like that.
Sure, that comes very much in handy.
You know, it takes an endeavor in mind to do the gadgetry stuff. I personally just think this is just fucking more kit.
When I get back home, I should ask my my parents to set up a school for this. I think it could have a lot of.
Yeah, everyone thinks schools are good, but sometimes not everyone needs the knowledge.
No, but we need the people with the knowledge.
Good luck with that.
Yes. Well, do a lot of work on the peninsula. And out in the sands. Part of the family business, I guess you could say. Skilled hands tend to
make light work.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Takes a drink. Let's switch gears.
Yeah.
So, Kasai goes over to some other part of the bar. Dane. I see you watching us from all the way over here. Well, it's like, I don't know, 10 feet away, maybe.
its own little quiet nook in this tavern space. What is wrong?
Nothing that we haven't already created a plan to handle.
She squints at that.
Sits down a few. She has a drink with her.
As a bartender comes by, she orders another one for you and for her. She doesn't order the gin, she just orders you a mead.
Oh yeah, the gin is just there. Hasn't taken a sip of it.
Yep.
It weighs heavy on you. What happened? More so than I thought it would, if I'm being honest. What troubles you so?
It was one of ours.
She nods. Yes. Yes, he was.
And we failed.
Do we agree, yes. But also no. You were listening earlier to us, no?
She definitely hears him say under his breath, "I."
The fault is not ours nor yours, solely, Udine. He was a boy born of hag's blood. A fairy tale come to life. And not a happy one. You cannot shoulder that burden and blame on your own. It would have been a struggle. Maybe impossible to have cleared them from that sort of lineage.
He just like looks forward and then down to the drink and then back at her. I could have done it.
He has a smirk on her face.
If it actually mattered to me at the time, I could have done it.
Her smirk goes away as you say that. I was going to say if anyone could have done it, I would have believed you could, yes. But then, what you just said.
She leans in closer to you. Not like inches away face to face, but she just gets a closer look at you. Opens her mouth to say something, but stops herself and decides that perhaps actions are the better part of words, or have a hand over words. And she gets up and sits on the table, not disturbing any of the offering you've left there, and brings you in close. Just sort of perching your head against her side as she sort of sits opposite from you.
You are different than when I first met you. And I am different from when you first met me. I can tell this now. I am sorry, Udine. We could have done more for Brendan. We could have done more in the past and when he was taken, but there's no point in discussing that now. Only that we never forget it. And look forward to whatever plans we have next. Vengeance or otherwise.
She probably sees his, like, hand that was gripped just relax. Vengeance won't bring him back. Won't change the fact that we failed. Nor can we change any action we take.
She ever so slowly uncradles you, your head rather, and sits back down to where she was before. The only thing I can think of in pale mockery of actually having done right by Brendan when he was with us is his brother. Number 111, as he calls himself. But again, that is only a pale mockery of what it could have been. But it might be our only step in recompense. He takes a drink.
Just, like, looks back. How many people have lost their lives? And the world turns, never having remembered them.
Countless. And besides, it depends anyways. You do not know the Nevros legends I know. And I do not know your provincial mythos. Our histories are not the same. There are certain people in mine that are forgotten by you, and vice versa. History does not remember everyone, and it has no obligation to. I personally do not care if history remembers me. I only wish to be remembered by those I care about.
She just, like, sees him, like, thousand-yard stare. I'll make sure history remembers you.
She gets a bit of a sad smile on her face.
Do or do not, Udin. I do not mind. I am not person for glory, for songs made of me.
Silas, yes. You, yes. Ajay, yes. Focus your energies more on them, but me, I... She does a dismissive wave of the hand.
I know where my soul goes now. And that is enough. And there I will see all those I hold dear. And they will remember me.
It's like sort of continues staring, like going to make sure no one forgets who we were. All of us.
If anyone can do it, I believe you can. But just hold yourself true when you do this. History remembers the terrible, too. I'd rather be forgotten than remembered for that.
Next drink.
You just see like him take like a deep breath and all of a sudden it's back to normal. The first thing, we need to worry about hunting.
Indeed. And seekers and slayers are, from what I hear, probably some good company for that. Even if they have a bit of stigma. So, you two can enjoy drinks for the evening.